shall be had, sir.
Isaiah 55.
Those two gone. This is only the beginning. Then all of you will go. One after the other, all of you.
I will never leave you, Mama.
You boy, if you should ever leave me, I'll be sorry I ever had babies.
Why did you have them?
Indeed, you goodness boy, why? To keep my hands in water and my face to the fire, perhaps.
For Mr. Ivar Morgan. From Windsor Castle it is.
Morgan is commanded to appear before her Majesty.
Mr. Ivor Morgan is commanded to appear before Her Majesty at Windsor Castle with chosen members of his choir on the 14th of May between the hours of 3 and 5.
To sing before the Queen. My son, I never thought to see this beautiful day.
Idris, Owen. All of you, fetch everyone from all the valleys round. Davy, over to the other collieries, invite everyone. It's a celebration, tell them. Yanto, down to the Three Bells for beer. Open house tonight for all who will come.
My sons, you shall have a send-off worthy the Morgans. Heavenly Father, I give thanks from the heart to live this day. I give thanks for all I have, and I do give thanks for this new blessing. For you are our Father, but we look to our Queen as our Mother. Comfort her in her troubles, O God, and let her worries be not more than she shall bear at her age. And grant that sweetness and power and spirit may be given to these voices that shall sing at her command. Amen.
Amen.
Harrod is down to the market.
And Harrod? Oh, I've come for Hugh.
For Hugh?
The daffodils are out, Mama.
Oh, Hugh.
Where are your clothes, boy?
Under my pillow.
Your pillow?
For these months, ready for today.
Come you then, and you shall bring back a posy fit for a queen. For your brave mother.
Indeed I will, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Almost there, you.
Yes, sir.
No bridge there. Watch out.
It's fun.
All right.
Yes, sir.
All right?
Yes, sir.
You can walk, you, if you try. Come, lad. You can walk.
Two. Walk. There's a good lad. Good old man.
You've been lucky, Hugh. Lucky to suffer. Lucky to spend these weary months in bed. For so God has given you a chance to make spirit within yourself. And as your father cleans his lamp to have good light, so keep clean your spirit, huh?
Yes, sir.
By prayer, Hugh. And by prayer, I don't mean shouting and mumbling and wallowing like a hog in religious sentiment. Prayer is only another name for good, clean, direct thinking. When you pray, think. Think well what you're saying. Make your thoughts into things that are solid. And that way, your prayer will have strength. And that strength will become a part of you, body, mind, and spirit. And the first duty of these new legs is to get you to chapel on Sunday.
Indeed they will, sir.
There's a good old man again.
Give me your hand. Come on now. Remain in your places. There's to be a meeting of the deacons.
Michael and Lewis, step forward. Your sins have found you out. And now you must pay the price of all women like you. You have brought a child into the world against the commandment. Prayer is wasted on your sort. You shall be cast out into the utter darkness till you have learned your lesson. Maitland Lewis, do you admit your sin? Then prepare to suffer your punishment.
Stop it!
Unharder!
Stop it! Leave her alone, you hypocrite!
Leave her now, Mr. Morgan. You!
Sit down!
Unharder!
How could you stand there and watch them? Cruel old men groaning and nodding to hurt her more. That is not the word of God. Go thou and sin no more, Jesus said.
Unharder! Your Bible too well, life too little.
I know enough of life to know that Michael and Lewis is no worse than I am.
Harrod.
Oh, what do the deacons know about it? What do you know about what could happen to a poor girl when she loves a man so much that even to lose sight of him for a moment is torture?
Easy now. You.
Unharad! Unharad! I am a man now. Kindly leave the kitchen.
Oh. So you're a man now, is it?
Blasphemy, sacrilege, and hypocrisy! Can a man smoke his pipe and read his paper on the Sabbath?
Oh, go and blow your nose.
Come in. Come in.
What under the blitz?
Good morning, Marlin.
Good morning, Mr. Evans. Sit down, sir. Sit down, sir.
Oh, thank you.
Mr. Evans, the mine owner himself. I heard.
Ah. Now to business, Warren.
Yes, sir.
I come here on a very delicate mission, Morgan.
No trouble, sir.
No trouble, but... it worries me.
Yes.
I'm here to get your permission that my son, Yeston, may have permission.
Sir!
Bless you, Morgan.
Thank you, sir.
Now, where was I?
Permission?
Oh, yes, that my son, Yeston, may have permission with your daughter's permission to call upon her. There we are.
We are a very proud family, Mr. Evans.
Yes, I know, Morgan, but this is not my doing, Morgan. Is that young what?
Mr. Evans, your son has my permission to speak to me.
Thank you. Thank you, Morgan. I'm very much obliged.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Good old Welsh blood, you know, and all that sort of thing. I'm very much obliged, Morgan.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Beth! Beth!
Come. My shoes. Get my shoes. You, girl, get up to your room. Have you no modesty left in you?
Get up there.
Take your hands.
My shoes! Find the shoes! Why didn't you...